For most of us, spiritual affairs occupy only a fraction of our time, if any. But devotees of the Lord try to detach themselves from material affairs and absorb their minds in spiritual life. And for those who are serious and sincere, Vrindavan is the ideal place. Thousands of pilgrims join the townspeople on festive holidays such as Govardhan Puja, when a feast like this one is offered to the Lord and then distributed. Rich or poor, everyone relishes this special food that has been offered to Krishna with love and devotion. There are many holidays throughout the year. This parade is held to celebrate the day when Krishna's eternal consort, Srimati Radharani, appeared. Sometimes walk 32 miles to circumambulate the Vrindavan area. For them, Krishna is still in Vrindavan as his deity and his holy name. Krishna is the center of attention, and he is served by everyone. Whatever is done in Vrindavan is meant for Krishna's service.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
More than a place on the map. To fully appreciate it takes an attitude of humble study and inquiry. Feeling of harmony with nature and the universe. And a spirit of love and devotion for Krishna. The transcendental exchange between Krishna and his devotee is tangible and real. But for non-devotees, it remains a mystery. ancient India's Vedic literatures, a great devotee prays, I worship Krishna, the primeval Lord, whose figure of beauty is tinged with the hue of rain-filled clouds, and who always revels in pastimes of love. I worship Krishna, who lives eternally in Vrindavan, where all speech is song and all walking is dancing. Vrindavan, the supreme abode, is known only to a very few, but is within the reach of everyone.
Mani mancha pare, pare.